We start the center stage debate in 2 minutes from now, but before that, here's what's happened through the day. Up to 6 hours of outages every day for over a week, and temperatures soaring to about 47 degrees Celsius. That's what people in the capital are living with. Delhi's power crisis is getting worse, and there seems to be no immediate solution in sight, even though Power Minister Piyush Goyal says he will fix the problem in 15 days. However, we're seeing the Aam Aadmi Party and the Congress both target the central government, and the BJP minister is saying, don't blame me, we've been in power for only 15 days, it's the Congress government which must take the blame.
Temperature and tempers both rising in the capital as it continues to reel under persistent power cuts. For over a week now, residents in Delhi have been suffering outages for up to 6 hours every day. Power Minister pushed the emergency button, calling a meeting with Lieutenant Governor Najib Jung. But he was quick to blame the previous Congress regime for the current crisis.
The real constraint that is causing such agony to the citizens of Delhi is clearly the lack of decision making, the lack of investment in infrastructure, the lack of any forward planning in the last 12 years since 2002.
Congress was ready to hit back. Even the Aam Aadmi Party joined in the war of words.
Bijli ko leke pichle 15 din se, khas taur se jab se unki sarkar bani hai, Delhi mein haahakar macha hua hai. दिल्ली का आम आदमी दुखी है, हर आम आदमी दुखी है कि साहब इतना संकट कभी नहीं देखा बिजली का, इतनी गर्मी दिल्ली वालों ने कभी नहीं देखी और इतनी बिजली की कमी दिल्ली वालों ने कभी नहीं देखी।
केजरीवाल
जिसने 15 साल दिल्ली में शासन किया, उसके साथ मिलकर यहाँ 49 दिन सरकार चलाते हुए किसी तरह का कोई काम नहीं किया धरने प्रदर्शन के अलावा। उनसे जाकर हिसाब किताब लें, उनसे जाकर पूछें कि 49 दिन तुमने क्या राज करने की बजाय बिजली की ट्रांसमिशन लाइन्स को ठीक करने की बजाय, बिजली के ट्रांसफार्मर्स के लिए मीटिंग करने की बजाय प्रदर्शन तुम क्यों करते रहे।
हमारी जो सरकार 15 वर्ष दिल्ली में रही है, दिल्ली के लोग खुद इस बात के चश्मदीद गवाह हैं कि पिछले 10 सालों में जो इन्वर्टर लोग घरों में लगाया करते थे उनका इस्तेमाल ख़त्म हो गया था। दिल्ली के अंदर जहां महज 1800 से 2000 मेगावाट बिजली की डिमांड होती थी, 5600 मेगावाट तक गई।
As political parties bicker, there seem to be no end in sight for capital's power woes. Maximum power consumption, which is at 5,338 megawatts, is expected to go up to 6,200 in the coming days. The gap between demand and supply is 450 megawatts due to faults in transmission. And the Bhavana and Pragati power plants are still not generating electricity to their maximum capacity. Bureau report, headlines today.
Okay, it's time to get started with the center stage Twitter debate for tonight. Once again, here are the rules and here is how you can participate. And what we are most keen on is getting all of you to engage live while our speakers make their points. Here's how you can participate. Use the hashtag center stage, agree or disagree, add your comments. The question we are debating tonight, is the opposition right in blaming the central government for the power crisis that Delhi currently faces? I want you to meet our guests this evening. Representing the Congress Party, former Minister, Senior Leader, Dr. Kiran Walia. Representing the BJP tonight, Siddharth Nath Singh, National Spokesperson, and representing the voice of the consumers, A.K. Datta, consumer rights activist who's worked very hard on electricity in the capital. I want to go across first to Dr. Kiran Walia. And ma'am, you will have 1 minute when no one will interrupt. You get to make your opening arguments on why people should believe that it is the central government led by the BJP which is to blame for the power crisis. The power minister is blaming you and what you did over the last 10 years in not augmenting power capacity. And that's the reason Piyush Goyal says is responsible for what people in the capital are facing. How can you blame a government that's been around only for 15 days for what the people of Delhi are suffering? Dr. Walia, your time starts now.
No, I'm sorry. I would blame the Aam Aadmi Party, which came into power after we had left the governance, and the new government that's come in the power in the center, I think is it would be exaggeration to blame them, because we have to give them time to take up. This is a capital, but at the moment there is a kind of a central rule in Delhi, and they could measure up, and they could perhaps, there has been a silence on their part for quite some time, but yes, we have to give them time, and we have taken the matter to the Lieutenant Governor, the Chief Secretary, and hopefully they will convey it to the central government. But when it comes to the Aam Aadmi Party, that's my focus. And the Aam Aadmi Party, when it came, it spoiled everything that the Congress Party had done. During 15 years, it had really rolled back the confusion, the chaos created by the preceding Bharatiya Janata Party, 1993 to 1998.
Okay, ma'am, the buzzer's gone off. Your time is up. You've distanced yourself from what Avrinder Singh Lovely, your party colleague, said. He said Delhi is being run by the governor, who's the representative of the centre. The responsibility for the dismal power situation lies in the Narendra Modi-led NDA government and Power Minister Piyush Goyal. Kiran Walia saying that she wants to blame more the Aam Aadmi Party and not so much just yet the BJP. So you're now saying what Arvinder Singh Lovely is saying is incorrect. Have I understood that correctly? You're blaming Arvind Kejriwal, Dr. Walia?
I'm not saying it's incorrect. I'm saying now we are under the central rule. So the central government should have, like Mr. Modi and the government has responded very fast to even the SAR countries' issues. They could have come up and done something about Delhi much before than now waking up to such a situation.
Okay.
But it's the Aam Aadmi Party.
Okay, you made your comment.
You've chaos that has come about.
You're blaming the Aam Aadmi Party. You're also saying it's now the central government's responsibility. And Siddharth Nath Singh, the reality is that people in Delhi for the last 10 to 12 years have not suffered power crisis and power cuts as bad as they are. And especially the Aam Aadmi Party is targeting you, saying that the BJP coming to power is what is responsible for the power crisis that people now are facing. How do you respond to the direct charges being leveled by the Aam Aadmi Party, which is blaming your government for not being able to help out and ensure that the people of Delhi remain cool and calm? Siddharth Nath Singh, your 1 minute starts now.
Well, Rahul, political upmanship will continue. But the real problem is in Delhi that there is no generation problem. There is an evacuation problem because of poor transmission and poor distribution network. The infrastructure which should have been created for this distribution and transmission has not been added to the Delhi. And therefore, to blame anybody who comes for 2 weeks, let me also answer that the Aam Aadmi Party, that even putting up two transmission lines will take more than 30 days. That's the problem. So they have not invested into infrastructure, the Congress particularly, not the Aam Aadmi, but the Congress particularly has not invested in Delhi on the infrastructure to evacuate power. And therefore, today, Bhavana Gas, which can produce 1500 megawatts, is only producing 290. And even today, the full gas is supplied to
them. Okay, your time is up, Siddharth Nath Singh. You are blaming the Congress government for not having done enough work over the past 10 years to ensure that supply would be more than demand. You're saying that because capacities weren't augmented, which is why Delhiites face this problem. AK Datta is a neutral consumer rights activist. We are hearing the charges and the counter charges as a representative of the customers and the consumers of Delhi. Mr. Datta, who do you think is really to blame? Is it the Aam Aadmi Party, the Congress, or the BJP? Mr. Datta, your time starts now.
No. This crisis is artificial. This has been created by the DISCOM. They have ample power. They have 6,200 megawatts booked, long-term power purchase agreement, which gives them enough supply, and Delhi has 30% surplus power. It is the mismanagement, and they are trying to blame it on others. But the Delhi is under president's rule during the last four, five months. Why the government is not taking action against them? Why is the DERC keeping quiet? DRC should take action against the DISCOM for failure in performance. Why is not the take? They have surplus power. I am filing a petition tomorrow against the DISCOM for taking against the DISCOM to the DRC for taking action against them. They surreptitiously sells cheap power, which Singrauli sells us at 1 rupee 44 paisa outside, and they are forcing the public.
Sir, the buzzer has gone off. Your time, Mr. Datta, is over. Prashant Bhushan from the Aam Aadmi Party is also now joining us on this broadcast. Prashant Bhushan, sir, Kiran Walia from the Congress attacked the Aam Aadmi Party, saying it's the chaos that the Aam Aadmi Party generated in its 49 days in power that is responsible for the power crisis that Delhi faces today. They're saying it's not the BJP because they've been in power for only 15 days. It's not the Congress because there were no big power cuts when the Congress was in power. The Congress is directly blaming the Aam Aadmi Party for the problems that the capital confronts. You've got one clear, uninterrupted minute to make your argument, and your time, Mr. Bhushan, starts now.
It's really remarkable that the Congress, which had been in power for 10 years and was essentially running the government through the central government after the Aam Aadmi Party resigned after having been in power for 49 days in Delhi, is now blaming the Aam Aadmi Party for the power crisis today. I mean, whose responsibility was it to have ensured that these transmission towers, which were damaged in the storm, get repaired? Whose responsibility was it to have anticipated the power demand in this heat wave and have arranged for additional power? Whose responsibility was it to have ensured that Reliance, which has reduced the supply of gas from 80 MMCMD to 8, to only 10% of what they were supposed to supply? As a result of
Mr. Bhushan, you've asked some important questions, but your 1 minute has gone off. I'm coming back to you in just a moment. Siddharth Nath Singh will respond to the charges that you've leveled. But before that, here are the live sentiment analysis scores that we have at this time. Remember, this is a Twitter debate. You're free to participate. We're getting a lot of responses. 89% of the people who've responded so far, 89% of them are responding in the negative, which is there, and 11% are responding in the positive. Remember, the question was, is the opposition wrong to blame the center for the power crisis? Clearly, in the initial sentiments that we've seen so far, people do not believe that the opposition is right. They're essentially saying that governments in the past should have done much more. But Prashant Bhushan raises important questions which Siddharth Nath Singh must respond to. Whose responsibility was it to anticipate the rise in the demand in power? These are things Prashant Bhushan suggests, Siddharth, your government should have prepared for, been ready for, and people shouldn't have been suffering if your government knew what it was doing. How do you respond to Prashant Bhushan, Siddharth?
Well, let me only say, we have been here for 15 days. Mr. Prashant Bhushan's government was there for 49 days. You couldn't anticipate and do the right thing except cutting the wires of the meters. So you should have, you got 49 days, we got just 15 days, and you are comparing with us, Mr. Prashant Bhushan. The fact of the matter remains that there, 10 years of governance of Delhi by the Congress and at the center should have been responsible enough, sensitive enough to look at the DISCOMs and ensure, as per the agreement, have they augmented the transmission, distribution and evacuation through the grids. When you buy the power from outside Delhi, when you buy the power, the grid is augmented or not. And that has not been done by the Congress government. So the real fault lies in the infrastructure, not at the generation side. So what we have offered is, in the short term, yes, we will correct those lines and transmission lines, which will take 10 to 12 days. And subsequently, we have to augment and improve the infrastructure. So I think we have taken a positive step.
Okay, your 1 minute is over, but you are arguing once again that it is the Congress which has been in power in Delhi for the longest period of time. These are long-term structural issues about how the power sector, Dr. Kiran Walia, in the capital is arranged. And therefore, for you to blame Prashant Bhushan's party for its 49 days in power, or for Arvinder Singh Lovely to blame the BJP government, is simply not correct, because it is Sheila Dixit and you were a minister in that government and you were in power for the longest time. These are long-term structural problems which can't, to which solutions can't be found either in 49 days or in 15 days, Dr. Walia.
I would like to correct Mr. Prashant Bhushan. We have been in power for 15 years and not for 10 years. 15 years by the will of the people. And because we had put so many things in order, the proof of the pudding lies in eating. Now, everywhere it is visible, it is felt, it has been realized that these people who came into power, the Aam Aadmi Party, instead of putting any attention on a summer plan, which is always done, the peak power requirement that is there, how will they measure up to it? What are the transmission line repairs that they're going to undertake? All the repair is a continuous affair. Maintenance is a continuous affair. Power augmentation, what is the power that they're going to buy? They had not made any provision, any budgetary provision, excepting for false promises to the people, 50% reduction in their power bills, this and that, and all those who supported
it. Okay, your time, madam, is up. You're again blaming the Aam Aadmi Party for not making adequate preparations in the winters, for setting right the transmission lines, for buying additional power. You're saying all of that when Arvind Kejriwal was doling free power is what the Aam Aadmi Party should have really been focusing on. And Mr. Prashant Bhushan, we've seen Manish Sisodia from your party suggest that there were no power cuts when you were in power, but you were in power in winter. Then no power cuts in the winter. Kiran Walia is saying you didn't plan when you were in power for the summer, which is why Delhiites are suffering. How do you respond, Mr. Bhushan?
You see, the planning has to be done. These are short-term power purchase agreements that have to be entered into just prior to the summer by anticipating the power requirement for the summer. But I want to raise two further questions. Why is it that all the VIP areas, all these ministers' houses, get uninterrupted power supply for running all their ACs, etc., while other poorer, particularly the poorer colonies where lower middle class people, etc., live, they are subjected to huge power cuts? And secondly, why is it that Reliance, which has dropped its supply of gas to 10% of what they were supposed to supply, what they were required to supply, why is it that no penal action is being taken against them, and instead of that they are being sought to be rewarded by doubling the gas prices? That the Congress government tried to double the gas prices, we got it stopped through the Election Commission.
So your time is up. The 1 minute has gone off. That's the difference in this format and all other television shows. When you're speaking, nobody will interrupt. But when the buzzer goes off, that's where the argument must conclude. I've got some tweets that I'd now like to play out, because this is about making it as interactive as possible for our viewers. Atul Singh PM writes with the hashtag center stage, the governor, the lieutenant governor should have planned for summers when state and center governments were off one party for 10 years. Ash25 Win writes in saying the Congress government is responsible for not being able to foresee power crisis when they ruled over for 10 years. Disagree, the new government is not a magician to solve the crisis, which is the result of corruption and inefficient handling. So those are some interesting tweets, and once again the blame squarely being leveled at the Congress, because being in power for the longest, it seems, Mr. Bhushan, the charges that you are leveling don't seem to be generating much traction, because people believe it's the Congress. While you are of course keen on going after the BJP, the Congress being in power for 15 years is seen as the villain in this piece, Mr. Bhushan.
Against the Congress party, I am also leveling the main charges against the Congress party, because they were in power.
Oh, and absolutely.
They continued to be
yes,
in power.
Mr. Dutta wants to come in and make a point. This is a free flowing round. We've got about 4 minutes
really
to go. Mr. Dutta, you've heard the charges, you've heard the counter charges. What sense are you making of this, Mr. Dutta?
During the last 5 years, more than 10,000 crore has been spent on infrastructure, that is lines and improving the distribution system. It is not right, nothing has been spent. This money has been paid by the Delhi consumers only. It is not nobody else. And about in 2009, when they could not perform, Delhi Commission fined them 1.68 crores. They deserve to be punished. This is the artificial problem which has been created by the DISCOM, who are selling the cheap power outside and forcing Delhiites to buy power at higher rate so that the tariff goes up. This is entirely artificial, and the lieutenant governor or the governor's rule has not been able to effectively control.
No, but what is Piyush Goyal and the BJP going to do about it? The fact that electricity companies are selling cheaper outside Delhi, forcing Delhi consumers to pay more and not even get proper regular electricity supply. Siddharth Nath Singh, what's your response to the charges being leveled by Mr. Dutta?
Well, what Mr. Dutta is saying, I won't disagree But yes, we need to look into DISCOMs, what they have done, why the infrastructure, if that money that they have received, why it has not been invested. So all those things needs to be looked in. But there is an immediate problem in our hand, which has been addressed by Piyush Goyal as a power minister in the morning, sitting along with the chief secretary and the lieutenant governor. So I think what Mr. Datta is saying, it will be looked into it. And if there is any anomalies which has happened, certainly I can assure through your channel, the BJP government or the NDA government at the center will take strictest action against all these people.
Mr. Datta,
that I can assure.
As the voice of the customers, are you reassured by what Siddharthnath Singh and Piyush Goyal are saying, that in 15 days they will set right what the Congress wasn't able to do in 15 years, they say?
In fact, if BJP wants, if the central government wants, it can be solved, because there is no problem. It is an artificial problem. It is the DISCOMs are law unto themselves. They behave in an arrogant manner. This is the creation of the DISCOM. There is no problem. There was no damage. There was hardly any damage in the storm, and that they should have restored supply within 3 hours. It is all man-made, and the lieutenant governor must take adequate action against them so that these DISCOMs behave properly.
Well, all that we've seen so far are charges, counter-charges and promises. The question is, can those promises now be translated into reality? That is what the consumer wants at the end of the day. Let's play out now the final sentiment analysis that we've got. 86% have responded in the negative, which means only 14% of the people feel it is correct of the opposition to blame the center for what is going on. 86% saying you can't blame the center just at this time, but that's also because it's only been a couple of weeks. Let's just see how it's been over all the 5 minutes that this program has been on. When we started, 89% were against the motion, 91, 88, 89, 86, 86. So it's been fairly constant, and those are the final results now on your screen. Clearly, Siddharthnath Singh, while you've got some grace now, that grace won't last forever. 15 days is what Piyush Goyal has asked for.
Rahul,
Prashant Bhushan, the Aam Aadmi Party and the Congress, people like Mr. Datta, and most importantly, the consumer, are watching out very carefully. Prashant Bhushan, I'm out of time. You've got just 10 seconds to make your final point. Tonight, it seems people prepared to give the BJP a chance to get their act in order, sir. Mr. Bhushan.
Yes, I want to ask the BJP government that we had ordered CAG audit of these distribution companies. It has been reported by the CAG to the High Court that the DISCOMs are not cooperating with the CAG audit. What does the central government
that's
now?
That's a very important
BJP
question, and that's a straight question to you, Siddharthnath Singh.
These DISCOMs,
you must answer that question that Prashant Bhushan has raised. Very quickly, 10 seconds.
Rahul, I am not aware of this issue.
Of course you are. It's been in the national newspapers every single day, Siddharthnath Singh. You can't claim that you're not aware of this issue.
Certainly I'm not, if you wish to believe. But I will tell, I'll ask Mr. Prashant Bhushan to direct call up Piyush, who's always available on his mobile, and he'll get an answer.
No, you're dodging this question, but Prashant Bhushan has asked
an important question. But I can't really help.
There is a CAG audit that's now been asked for. Will the BJP government allow for a CAG audit on the electricity supply companies? Because that's something that the Aam Aadmi Party has been asking for. It became a very volatile issue. Right now, Siddharthnath Singh trying very hard to duck that issue. A clearer answer would have been better. But I'm out of time. So this is where it ends. But Prashant Bhushan raising an important point. Yes, Siddharth, I'm out of time, so 5 seconds.
Duck it, but answer is to be given by Piyush Goyal.
Okay, so you will check with Piyush Goyal and you will come back and we will ask Piyush Goyal that question. I end this debate tonight. Dr. Kiran Walia, Prashant Bhushan, Siddharthnath Singh and Mr. Datta for joining us on the Center Stage Face-Off. You've got grace, but that's only for 15 days. People may turn around if after 15 days things haven't been fixed.